Just so you know, I'm a very big fan of Marvel, and recently their series, Loki, is by far my most favorite series of all time. So I thought it would be fun to make one of the characters come to life. Meet Ms. Minutes. She's an AI character in Loki, who works for a fictional agency called Time Variant Authority, which is controlled by Kang the Conqueror. Ms. Minutes can do a lot of stuff in the series. She can talk, interact with other characters, and of course, fetch data and information, almost like Friday and Jarvis in movies. So that's what I exactly did. What is the time?
1:37 p.m.
Tell me a joke.
What do you get when you put a vest on an alligator? An investigator.
But I did cheat a lot, or let's say borrowed a lot of things that are already available to get to this point very quickly. So make sure you watch till the end of the video to build your own personal assistant, Ms. Minutes. Usually, I start with electronics and work my way up to building the enclosure. But this video is going to be a little different. First, I'm going to make the enclosure, then build the electronics around it. Before I started modeling, I tried searching if someone had already done similar project. And I found this amazing Ms. Minutes clock project by Thingiverse user Philip He. But unfortunately, at the time of recording, the project is down. Anyway, I had downloaded the STL file a few weeks back, so instead of me creating the project completely from scratch, I'm going to edit and remix this project for my need. I'll make sure to give a link in the description where you can download this modified STL files. Once the STL file was ready, it was time to print. I took the model into Cura and sliced it. You can either use a single color to print and then paint the eyes and outlines, or change the filament while printing as I did. It approximately took 9 hours for complete the print for this model. During the print, I had to change the filament 3 times. But still, somehow I managed to mess it up by not selecting the proper layer height to change the color. So once it's printed, I spent few minutes carefully removing the support materials. But I was not happy with the color of the model. So to fix this, I used a black marker for the outline and a whitener for the eyes. After messing it for a while, it was done. It looks way better than the original color I printed it with. Since the model is ready, we can start with the brain for Ms. Minutes. I'm going to use a Raspberry Pi 0W for the hardware, and for the software, I'm going to cheat a bit. Instead of writing any custom AI or use fancy libraries to build a voice assistant, I'm going to use a Google Assistant SDK. This wouldn't be possible 2 years ago because Google Assistant SDK did not support Raspberry Pi 0. But recently last year, they released a new Google Assistant service which does support all sort of hardware including Raspberry Pi 0W. Before messing up with voice assistant, let's deal with the hardware issue we have first. You can see Raspberry Pi 0W does not have any sort of audio input or audio output. To fix this, I used a USB sound card with a micro USB to full size USB adapter. This will take the audio input and output through USB and send it to respective audio peripherals. For the audio input, let's use a collar mic because this will nicely fit within Ms. Minutes' nose. But the 3.5mm jack that comes with the collar mic does not work with the sound card. So I replaced it with this audio jack. And for the audio output, we can use any regular speaker. But if that's the case, we'll end up building a audio amplifier circuit as well. So instead, I'm going to use a desktop speaker which is powered by USB. The audio hardware might seem a bit tricky to set up, but it's fairly easy. Even the Google Assistant service documentation have a hardware guide on how to set up the speakers and microphone. First, install the Raspberry Pi OS on the SD card. If you are not sure how, check out my video on how to set up Raspberry Pi without a monitor and keyboard. Once you have the OS and SSH into the Raspberry Pi, we can start with the setup process. Check if the Raspberry Pi is detecting the sound card by using the command lsusb. Now check the microphone and speaker connection by the command arecord-l and aplay-l, and note down the card ID and the device ID. Once you have the ID, create a new file called arecord-rc in /pi and paste this code, and replace the card number and the device ID with your ID found in the previous commands. Finally, adjust the volume using the command Alsa Mixer. And that's it. You can use this command to record the audio.
This is a recording, testing, 1, 2, 3.
And this command to play the audio you recorded.
Testing microphone, 1, 2, 3.
You don't have to worry about the commands I'm using. Most of these are given in the Google SDK documentation. And the link for this documentation is given in the description. Now let's set up the Google Assistant API. Go to this link and create a new project. And set any arbitrary name for your project. On the next page, scroll down to the bottom and select the device registration. From here on, you can follow my instructable or use the Google documentation to set up the Google Assistant SDK. Because it is a little bit lengthy process. Just like the hardware, most of the setup instructions are already given in the Google Assistant documentation. Once you have set up the SDK, we can test the assistant. Enter this command and replace the project ID and the model ID. Once you have set up the Google Assistant SDK, you can download this repo and open the file pushtotalk.py. Then remove these lines from the code. This will help you to talk to Google Assistant without pressing the enter key. That's it, you are done. It's time to put everything into the enclosure. First, let's start with the placement of the power supply, then followed by Raspberry Pi 0W and the sound card. Now we can fit the microphone. For the speaker, I'm going to open up the desktop speaker and take the speaker out. And just like we did with the microphone, I change the audio jack of the speaker to minimize the space. Then I soldered everything together and stuck them with some hot glue to stay in place. Finally, add some heat inserts and cover the back of Miss Minutes.
The answer is 17, 17, 98, 69,184.
What is time variant authority?
On the website marvelcinematicuniverse.fandom.com, they say, "The Time Variance Authority is a bureaucratic organization created by he who remains located outside of space and time that is tasked with preserving the sacred timeline and preventing the creation of branching timelines."
Who played the character Miss Minutes?
Tara Strong. On the website sci-fi.com, they say, "Did they have any ideas on what direction they wanted you to take Miss Minutes, or was it more like, she's Tara Strong, we're going to stay out of her way? When you have an audition for an animated character, they'll give you a drawing of the character, a character bio, something about their world."
This brings us to the end of the video. If you like the video, make sure to hit the like button and be sure to be subscribed to the channel if you haven't already. Because there are going to be a lot more projects upcoming soon. Until then, you can watch my other videos from the link on the screen or the link in the description.